Randvi, are you well? You seem distant.
I'm fine. Only a little tired, but well enough. Shall we look at the map?
Not until you tell me what is wrong.
Oh, I think I have. I feel somewhat trapped. In this room, and this settlement, and this life.
I cannot help you with your life just now, but I can get you out of this room. What do you say?
I don't know. There is much work to be done.
Stop. Forget about alliances and responsibility for just a few hours. We could take a ride to Grandbridge or somewhere nearby for a change of pace.
That sounds lovely. And too far to consider just now. But thank you, Eivor. Maybe another time. Now, what was it you needed?
Randvi, take a break. Let us make for Grandbridgeshire and get you out of this musty room.
Do you mean now? Right now?
Of course. You said you were tired of all this, so why not stretch your legs and fill your lungs?
I did ask, didn't I? You're right. Lead the way, Eivor.
We will need to cross the river at some point if we want to enter Grandbridgeshire. If you know a better way, I would love to hear it.
Is swimming not an option?
Swimming? I don't know. Are you joking?
A boat or a horse would always do, but I'm not opposed to the more traditional methods. This water smells off.
You get used to it.
I do not wish to. Eivor, there. What is that?
This is where the Summer Army retreated when Grandbridge was lost. They seem to have resettled the city in full now.
Right, right. I know this land so well by its map, but to see it in person brings it to stunning life. A Roman marvel. I will not soon forget this sight.
And here we are. Welcome to Grandbridge. We should make our way to the longhouse.
Ah, it's bigger than I imagined. Rustic, woody, beautiful. And everything seems quite new.
Under Soma's guidance, the Summer Army built this town up from a small village. They wanted a hub for trade near London, and a launching point for incursions into Wessex.
Well, it is impressive. Some interesting architectural ideas here, too.
I know you, I think. One of Soma's loyal men. Magni, is it?
Yeah. Good memory.
Good to see you again. This is Randvi, a dear friend and a sturdy fighter.
Well met, Randvi. Eivor seems to have a preference for befriending lovely women.
You know, I noticed the same thing.
I expected more people about, Magni. Has something happened?
Soma rounded up some warriors and took them west. She's hoping to open a new trade route with Oxenavode. Only now, in times of trouble, I have discovered I am not the surrogate leader I should hope to be.
What sort of trouble?
Oh, a pack of surly bandits have encamped nearby. To the east of the water's edge. They attack all merchants who travel here by river or road, and word is spreading quickly. It's keeping traders at bay.
That could cripple your town if it carries on too long.
It's crippled me already. The bastard stole my horse yesterday morning.
So what will you...
We can take care of them, Magni. And if we don't find your horse, we will steal you a new one.
Well, that would ease my mind. I have nothing to offer you for this deed, but the bandits surely would. Take from them what you like.
Good. Consider the matter handled. Eivor, come. We have a camp to raid. The bandits are camped on the river, he said. East of the water's edge.
You volunteered us for a fight, Randvi. Is that your idea of a pleasant ride through the country?
It must be. I surprised even myself.
Away from the table for a day and already you are lusting for blood.
A feeling you must know well, no? I have always wanted to experience the world as you do, and now I will. Unless you have a more interesting day planned for us.
We will help Magnian clear these bandits. But do not be rash when we find them. The Raven Clan needs your steady hand.
Yes, indeed, my lord. I shall follow your order to the letter.
If I did not know any better, I would say you're teasing me.
Oh, certainly not, Eivor Wolf-kissed, iron-fisted Drenger. I would never tease one with such commanding authority.
Your life ends now!
That was a thrill, Eivor. We are champions of Grandbridge. Do you know of any other towns that need liberating?
You don't think we have had enough drama for one day? We should return to the settlement.
Or we could have a drink to celebrate our victory.
At home. Tekla has all the mead and ale we could want.
Eivor, our outing has hardly begun. Find us an alehouse and let us make ourselves at home.
Let's return the horse. And if your thirst remains, we'll look around. Magni, we solved your bandit problem.
Did you? Well done! And did you find my sweet mare?
Your horse is outside, waiting for you.
Thank the gods he is safe. And thank you, Eivor. And your friend Randvi, wherever she is.
She is here somewhere.
Eivor! Over here! Look at this!
Someone is thirsty!
What are you playing at?
A drinking contest. You versus me. Wolfkist versus Table Maiden.
Randvi, we can do better than Table Maiden.
Mead Queen, then.
All right. Let us drink.
Beautiful.
Oh, any more and I'll drown.
Ha! I am the Mead Queen, slayer of wolves and barrels. I told you I would drink you under the table.
So, are you satisfied? My head is ringing like a bell.
More than satisfied. Now come, we'll ride this off and take in the air as we head home. After just one more stop.
Ah, Randvi.
It's a sunken tower near a waterfall, close to home. We can stop for a look, and then you are free of me. It's near the highest point of a hill, just south of the settlement. Easy to spot, I'm sure.
All right, one last stop then.
I know it might not show, Eivor, but I am terribly excited.
Oh, it shows.
Keep up!
Mind where you put your fingers. These stones are old and weathered. You climb well for one who folds maps.
You jest, but I have raised the frames of longhouses and hammered the ribs of longships. My hands are calloused from hard work. A stunning view. It reminds me of my early years in Norway. How I used to climb the hills beyond the wood.
You have an adventurous heart. I hardly see it behind the table, but now I've watched you scale a tower in fur, soaking wet.
I was rowdy in my youth. Hunting, sailing. I was a wildling of the open air before I became this staunch and stoic woman. Married off in service of peace between two clans. A noble and worthy role, but not one I had ever imagined for myself.
You would have made a fine wandering warrior. A Jomsvikinger, free to come and go as she pleased.
I think so too. It may be we would have sailed together over the open seas, raiding or traveling.
Or faced each other on the field of battle. Without your marriage to Sigurd to secure peace, our clans might still be at war.
True. Very true. Thank you for today. Every bit of it has been a dream and I'm not keen to wake.
Then don't. We can stay here as long as you like.
Yes.
What was that?
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I shouldn't have. I got away from myself.
No need to apologize.
Sigurd is your brother, and I have put you in a very difficult position. The heart does not do politics like the head.
It may be the mead, it may be the air, but there's no need to apologize.
I am sober enough. But the truth of it is, I have felt this way for some time now. I care for you, Eivor.
That is comforting to hear. I have long felt the same way, but I banished the thought that this would ever happen.
Many times I wished to tell you. Wished to say what was in my heart and what I desired, but duty kept me from it.
Say all you like.
Today has meant so much. We rode, we fought, we drank, we laughed. You showed me your world. Not in words, but deeds.
Deeds are more direct than words.
Andri? Must have returned to the settlement. Ranvi, you left so suddenly.
There is work to be done. There always is.
I see.
But do not think for a moment that I have forgotten you and our wonderful day.
Nor would I wish you to.
Good. Then we see eye to eye.
And heart to heart.
Yes, indeed. Until our next moment alone, we should return to our great work. England will not pacify itself on our behalf.
No, indeed.
Back to work, then.
Come to me. Should we take this to your chamber?
No need.
I must be direct, Ranvi. Between you and me, this will not work. I am sorry.
That is quite direct. If you are sure, then you should know. It must be final.
No, forgive me. It was a moment of anxiety. Seeing you now has calmed me down.
I understand, Eivor. We all know these peaks and valleys from time to time.
I have long considered this, and I know it cannot work, not for me.
Painful to hear and painful to admit, but you may be right. It was foolish of me to think it could lead somewhere.